We got an action-packed show tonight. The first thing I would like to talk about with you, the listening audience, what is the worst song ever written? What is it? Help me figure out the worst song ever. Or actually, I think I know what it is. I think I know what the worst song ever written is. I want to see if you can guess it. 201-209-9368. Can you guess the worst song ever written? I think I have an idea what it is. Let's see if we can come to a consensus on what the worst song ever written is. 201-209-9368. FMU, you're on the air.
I know the worst song ever.
What is it?
Poison's Talk Dirty to Me.
I'm going to write that one down. I don't think that's it, though.
Dude, that is such a bad song.
Okay, let's see. It's all right. Well, I'm putting it on the list, but I don't think it's the worst ever, but we'll see. All thanks, right. Pat. Worst song ever, what is it? FMU, you're on the air.
How you doing? It's Run with the Fox by it's Chris Squire and Alan White from Yes.
Wow, that sounds pretty bad. So it's the drummer and bassist, am I right on that, of Yes?
Yes, it's like a solo thing for them.
Wow, so they couldn't get there. They're like, hey, we got, you know, Yes is kind of constraining with these 14-minute songs. We're not getting our, we don't have room to breathe.
Oh, yeah,
Yes.
Exactly. They really needed to, you know, go on the cutting edge there. And they basically talk about the ghosts of Christmas past. Ugh. And then you have to run with the fox, and now's the season, and now's the reason, and all that fun stuff.
Yeah, Tales from Topographic Oceans is holding us back, not letting us do our thing. This 29-minute, three-part song spread over three albums. We got to do, hey, Alan, let's do a solo album. Just you and me. We'll jam out.
It's absolutely the most awful song I have in my entire collection.
Chris Squire and Alan White, what is the song called?
It's called Run with the Fox.
That sounds epic. I'm going to see if we can track that down. I have a bad song in mind. I want to see. We'll see if we have that. We can check it out head to head.
All right.
Thanks. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye.
Please don't say bye-bye. You're not four. Please. Enough with the bye-bye. Officer Tom saying any Striper song. Striper, possibly. 201-209-9368. What is the worst song ever written? What is it? Paradise by the Dashboard Light. What? No. No, worst song ever. That's the most song ever. You just get... That's like Meatloaf trying to make sure you get your money's worth. What is the worst song ever? So far we got somebody saying Striper. We got an Alan White, Chris Squire, Run with the Fox, and somebody saying Poison, Talk Dirty to Me. FMU, you're on the air.
Oh, I would like to talk to Tom.
This is Tom.
Tom Scharpling.
Yes, who is this?
This is Don Knows, the pottery guy.
Don!
Yeah, how are you?
I'm okay, how are you?
I'm doing fine, I love your show.
I love and, your pottery.
You know, I was going to...
Don, I'd like to tell you a story for a moment. Did you hear about the pottery class where they gave two different commands during the pottery class?
No, I didn't.
They told one group of students to make... a pot every day, right?
Mm-hmm.
a vase every day.
Okay.
They told another group of students to make the perfect vase. They had all semester to make the perfect vase.
Okay.
End of the semester, they put all the vases next to each other.
Uh-huh.
The ones some students crafted theirs for months. Others were knocking out a vase a day. And do you know what the end result was?
A lot of pottery?
Beyond that.
I don't know.
Who made the best vases?
I would say probably the people that knocked out lots and lots and lots of pieces.
Exactly.
You can't be good if you don't produce large quantities of wear.
That's exactly it. You just do it.
I don't think about it. I just go about the process of making hundreds of pieces.
You just do it.
Yeah, and I don't intellectualize about it.
Now tell me, Don,
yes.
If you could, what is the worst song ever?
I still think it's Tie a Yellow Ribbon Around the Old Oak Tree.
That's pretty bad. That's Tony Orlando and Dawn.
Yeah, and I also was thinking maybe Yummy, 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 I've Got Love in My Tummy was pretty dreadful.
That's just literally the definition of bubblegum, though, right? That's not, not the end of the world.
Yeah, you know, I could have also gotten into, like, dissing plenty of Madonna songs or Britney Spears songs, but I don't even know that genre because, I'm way too old for that.
Sure. Now tell me, Don, where is my pottery that you promised
me? Actually, I have a beautiful piece sitting in my studio that is not glazed and finished that says, the best show on WFMU with the writing all on it, the vase. And it's just one of those back burner projects that every time I listen to your show on Tuesday, I look at it and go, shoot, I've got to finish that pot for Tom and send it in.
Nice.
So it shall arrive one of these days.
I can't wait.
Cool. Anyway, Tom, I think your idea for this particular call-in show is brilliant, and I'm enjoying it thoroughly as I sit at my potter's wheel.
Well, thank you, Don, and watch out for that kiln.
I will.
All right.
Thanks, Tom.
Bye.
Bye.
201-209-9368. What is the worst song ever written? FMU, you're on the air.
Yeah, I just think the worst song ever written is the song That Never Ends by that little Lamb Chop puppet.
You think Lamb Chop is responsible for the worst song ever?
Well, that lady that sold Lamb Chop and then wrote that song. That song is definitely the worst song ever.
All right.
Huh?
All right. Duly noted. Duly noted. 201-209-9368. Actually, I think the other Lamb Chop is probably responsible for the worst song ever, more so than Sherry Lewis and Lamb Chop. FMU, you're on the air.
Hi.
What's
worst song ever?
Yeah, what is it?
Well, anything by Phil Collins. There's something in the 80s that I heard way too much. The lyrics were something like Studio or something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, that's called
sense.
It's called Studio.
It was incessant.
It's awful. Thank you for your vote.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye.
FMU, you're on the air.
Hey.
Hey.
I think it's Ebony and Ivory.
Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson.
Yep.
Thanks.
No, Stevie Wonder.
Paul McCartney and Stevie Wonder.
Yeah.
Although me saying Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson brings to mind
We Are the World.
That song Say Say Say, which I think might even be worse than Ebony and Ivory.
Okay.
All right. Thanks,
buddy.
Bye. 201-209-9368 FMU, you're on the air.
Yes, hello. I think the worst song is Inagata Da Vida.
By Iron Butterfly. What?
That to me is the worst song ever produced.
Bon, no, 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 no.
Well, I guess we disagree.
You don't like heavy rock, do you?
No, 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 no.
You like soft stuff.
What's that?
You like soft stuff.
No, I don't like soft stuff.
You like music that's like Snuggle, right? Like Snuggle, the little soft bear that you throw into your washing machine.
There you go. That's more to my liking.
Good.
I mean, I like, I like good rock and roll. Not
sure,
like
the old stuff. No, 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 no,
your singing is so good that I can barely distinguish the notes.
My singing is so good? Is it really?
No.
It's not?
No.
What?
I hate to insult you over the air.
My singing's not good? Are you serious?
Well, at least on this phone it isn't.
What? What about on this song? When I think of those East End lights, muggy nights, curtains drawn, in the little room downstairs. Prima donna, Lord, you should have been there, sitting like a princess perched in her electric chair. And it's one more beer, and I don't hear you anymore. We've all gone crazy lately. My friends out there rolling on the basement floor. Someone saved my life tonight, Sugar Bear. You almost had your hooks in me, didn't you, dear? You nearly had me roped and tied. Altar bound, hypnotized, sweet freedom whispered in my ear. You're a butterfly, and butterflies are free to fly, fly away, high away from high by. Leaving showers, slippers hanging in my darkest dreams. Strangled by a horse scene, just a pawn out, clown out, bandit, dominating queen. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, damn it, listen to me, good. I'm sleeping with myself tonight. Save the time, and the music's still alive. And someone saved my life tonight, Sugar Bear. You almost had your hooks in me, didn't you, dear? You had me nearly passed in time. Altar bound, hypnotized, sweet freedom whispered in my ear. You're a butterfly, and butterflies are free to fly, fly away, high away, by by. Stocks and bonds, then joint me demands forever. But coming in the morning with a truck to take me home, someone saved my life tonight. 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 Someone save my life tonight.
So save the faith and run the field you play along. Someone save my life tonight. A sugar bear. You almost had your hooks in me, didn't you, dear? You nearly had me roped and tied.
Tonight. 201-209-9368. FMU, you're on the air.